Welcome everyone to the Presto Geosystems webinar, Professional Development Series, Protecting Slopes Against the Forces of Nature. I hope everyone is in good health and good spirits, and I'd like to thank you for taking time out of your day to join this webinar. I'm your host, Jose Pablo George, or JP, the International Business Development Manager with Presto Geosystems. We manufacture industry-leading erosion control, stormwater management, and porous pavement products, all made in the upper Midwest. Through an extensive national and international distribution network, we offer technical and site support, as well as free project evaluation from our in-house design engineering team. Today's presentation of Repair and Reduce Slope Erosion will focus on permanent stabilization solutions for slopes and embankments with GEOWEB GeoCells. Here are the things I hope you get out of today's presentation. Understand causes of surface erosion, learning about the GEOWEB system, how flexible and versatile it is, and know that the system can work on steep slopes. Just so everyone's aware, this presentation is about slope surface erosion only. We will not be talking about global stability of slopes today. If there are questions about global stability, we have an upcoming presentation on MSC walls and wall design. That will get more into detail for getting global stability. If there are any questions during the presentation today, please use the question tab and I'll get to them at the end. We're going to start with a very quick overview of the broad classes of slope erosion. The first and most obvious cause of soil erosion is water. High-intensity rainfall events and the resulting runoff can easily strip soil from a slope surface. But global failure can occur when pore pressures elevate and change the properties of soil particles, reducing inner particle strength. Water flowing through the slope, typically in dam embankments or reservoir slopes, can cause erosion through piping. Water flowing down the face of a slope, originating from rain or sheet flow, will cause rills and gullies. Shoreline erosion occurs when rivers, ponds, and lakes create current or wave action that attacks the underlying soil. And finally, while not truly considered erosion, misapplying erosion control blankets or turf reinforcement mats can lead to slope surface failure and required installation of a more stable slope protection system. Now, with all that refreshed in our minds, we'll move on to describing the GEOWEB 3D system. The GEOWEB system consists of two main attributes. The first is cell size, and the cells come in three diameters, small, medium, and large, with heights of 3, 4, 6, 8, and 12 inches. Cell aperture and height are selected following an evaluation of project-specific needs and site conditions. The ultrasonically welded seam, where all the connecting points are, is very important to the function of a geocell. The stronger the seam strength, the better the performance. And a strong seam allows for heavier infill material, steeper and taller slopes, and better lifetime performance. GEOWEB is produced using high-quality virgin high-density polyethylene resin for consistently strong welds at cell junctions, while also maintaining semi-rigid ductile properties within the cell walls, high stress crack resistance, and overall toughness and long-term durability in the environment. Our geocells do not use fillers or exotic polymer alloy blends, which can ultimately reduce weld strength and environmental stress crack resistance, and that are offered in some competing products in the name of increasing cell wall stiffness or in reducing material costs. To avoid weld failures and the damaging effects of differential settlement, uniformity in performance across all elements of a geocell system is much more important than stiffness alone. To facilitate installation, we offer 5 section lengths. The second attribute in the GEOWEB system is the infill material. There are 3 main infill types for slopes, depending on the type of protection needed: topsoil, aggregates, and granular soils, and concrete. In most cases, this allows for the use of on-site materials without the need to import fill. The system components are all of the supporting accessories that help the GEOWEB protect the slope. So I've got a simplified diagram here to show how the different components interact with the GEOWEB to form a complete system. We'll talk about each of these components next. To begin, we have our slope with some standard dimensions. First thing to go down is the planar geosynthetic layer, which can be a geotextile, geomembrane, geogrid, or any similar product. Then the GEOWEB is put in place. Note how the GEOWEB has a horizontal turn near the top of the slope. This is important for crest anchorage and for erosion control. We have 2 options for anchoring. One is using stakes or anchors. These are placed mid-slope and at the crest. The number and spacing of stakes is project dependent. The other option is to use tendons and a dead man, with the dead man being a buried pipe, concrete anchor, or earth or rock anchors at the crest. The GEOWEB is then filled with the desired infill material and if vegetated, an erosion control blanket is used until vegetation is established. The atrachy is the first component for a completely integrated system, connecting each individual panel of GEOWEB into a single web that covers the slope. It allows for faster installation of the GEOWEB and will last the lifetime of the project, ensuring that the slope is protected and that the GEOWEB system will not fail under anticipated loads. The specific engineering values of the atrachy will ensure the system holds up to loading over time without the corrosion seen in staples or the failure of underperforming cable tie systems. As slope angle increases, the driving force of the infill material exceeds the available frictional resisting force, and additional anchorage will be required. The ATRA anchors hold the GEOWEB to the slope and penetrate into the ground. If corrosion resistance is required due to project condition, Presto has high-density polyethylene ATRA speed stakes that are designed to work with the GEOWEB. We also supply ATRA stake clips for use with half-inch rebar, as shown in the photograph being driven by a Hilti hammer drill. For steep slopes, a slope where the native soil is highly erodible, or over a surface that cannot be punctured, such as a liner, tendons can be used. The ATRA tendon clips transfer the load from heavy infill material to the tendons and crest anchorage system. Only the ATRA tendon clip is specifically designed to fully transfer safely and securely the forces placed upon the geocell. Every accessory and every feature has been designed and tested to specifically work together so that we go from problem to design to construction solution with a system where the modeling replicates the real world forces. The GEOWEB works in multiple ways to protect the slope surfaces. It prevents significant movement of the soil by confining the soil to individual cells. By separating the soil into smaller chunks, the system resists mobilization of the entire slope face due to hydraulic loads and prevents soil erosion. Now, this is an important point. Proper installation of the GEOWEB includes embedding the GEOWEB into the crest of the slope. This prevents water from flowing beneath the GEOWEB and undermining the system. So no rills or gullies will form underneath the GEOWEB and lead to failure. The system provides a way to fully vegetate slope surfaces that otherwise could not support sustainable plant life, and increases the overall slope stability by interlocking with the vegetated root zone. Vegetated slopes are the most popular option for slope protection because they can result in the most attractive slopes with little to no maintenance long term. Permeable slopes can be installed where high rainfall is anticipated or when construction projects are located in arid conditions or arid locations. This approach can aid in the design of the project by limiting runoff from the slopes and allowing the water to permeate through the underlying soil. Hard armor slopes are most beneficial where very high water flows are anticipated, such as dam spillways or along channel walls. Here's a list of the typical project applications we see using the GEOWEB system. This is not an exhaustive list by any means, but it does give a good idea of the range of applications that the GEOWEB system can be used for. Going forward, I'll use some case studies to show how the GEOWEB system can be applied to different application types. Our first application type will be vegetated slopes. This case study was a vegetated slope over an unstable soil slope at an active gold mine in Canada, with variable length and face angles. An access road was going to be built above the slope, where the excavator is shown in the picture. So the slope had to be stable enough to support the expected road traffic and live load. Here we see space constraints at the toe of the slope in the form of another access road, so the slope could not be regraded into a gentler slope angle. A nice feature of the GEOWEB slope system is shown in the after photo, where the guardrail is installed at the crest and a fence is installed at the toe. There's no limit to this sort of infrastructure being installed near or on the GEOWEB panels, which is great in tight spaces like the one seen in these photos. This slope along a road in Ohio shows a common problem that is solved with the GEOWEB system. Erosion and washout of soil slopes onto road surfaces is a problem in many locations. Covering the slope with the GEOWEB system and filling it with topsoil allows for a vegetated slope without the concern of having to constantly replace the soil after storm events. We recommend that some sort of surface protection, such as hydroseeding or using erosion control blankets, can be used over the GEOWEB panels until vegetation has had a chance to grow. Embankments along roadways have to deal with sheet flow runoff from the impervious surface, like the slope here, for a Maryland State Highway Administration project. The sheet flow can cause sloughing of large sections of the upper topsoil layer, causing deep rills or gullies, and preventing vegetation from taking hold. The GEOWEB system holds the soil in place while allowing the water to run over the surface, so no more gullies and vegetation can form deep roots to further stabilize the slope. This is a great overhead shot of the GEOWEB system being installed on a slope. You can see the variability of the slope in terms of overall height and slope angle. And a large boulder is even left in place on the right side without causing significant interruption of the GEOWEB system. For this project, tendon anchorage was required, with the tendons terminated with earth anchors along the crest edge. And here's the finished product. A couple of months later, with full vegetation growth, the slope will last a lifetime. Okay, the next case study shows the GEOWEB system along a shoreline embankment of a large pond. This is also a vegetated system and was used to help stabilize the embankment and prevent further erosion. This crew did not take advantage of power hammer drills because it was a smaller project. sheet piles were put in place to allow for a dry construction environment. This time, the GEOWEB panels were anchored using stakes because the slope angle and slope height were very low. The GEOWEB was filled with native soil from the pond, so the same plants would grow over the area, creating a seamless look. Once the GEOWEB system was in place, the sheet piles were removed. There's now a thriving water garden in place with a much more attractive and stable shoreline that required very little maintenance. The next application type will be aggregate slopes. This was a steep slope adjacent to a railroad track. Here, vegetation was not enough to hold the slope in place, and after several record rainfall events that saturated the slope, we saw a slope failure. The existing vegetation was removed and the slope graded with a spider excavator before placement of the GEOWEB system. A non-woven geotextile was placed beneath the system. This helps keep the aggregate in place and prevents it from getting under the GEOWEB panels, which could damage the system and cause lifting. The GEOWEB sections expand like an accordion. The tendons can be threaded through the unexpanded sections for easy installation and then secured to the crest anchorage. A single worker can carry an unexpanded section of GEOWEB, so it is best to get as much done on the crest of the slope before expanding it downward. After tendons are inserted and after tendon clip load transfer device is connected, the GEOWEB sections are then draped over the slope and secured with the atrachies. Enough panels are pre-connected to reach the full length of the slope. The atrachies are able to connect two unexpanded panels of GEOWEB. And again, we recommend this is done on the crest to limit the amount of slope side work. The side-by-side connections were made after all the panels were laid over the slope. This connects all the panels and creates a single slope protection system. With a shallower slope, the crewman could walk on the slope to connect the sections, but in this case, a man lift was used for safety and efficiency. Presto always recommends that the panels be filled from the top of the slope to the bottom. This ensures there's not an undue amount of weight pulling at the bottom of the panels, which could damage the system. Also, note that you can place a load on the GEOWEB immediately after the cells are filled. and the final solution. This permeable aggregate slope required no maintenance. It's perfectly all right for the GeoWeb cells to be visible, as you see in a couple cases here. It will not affect the system performance. The permeable aggregate reduces water runoff and eliminates the potential for fallen vegetation on the tracks below. Minnesota DOT used the GeoWeb system to help stabilize the surface around bridge abutments and along railroad tracks and crossings. The flexible nature of the GeoWeb panels means it can easily contour to the slope face and around obstacles such as piles and abutments. With the system in place, water erosion is prevented around the abutments, reducing maintenance costs. The entire project was a mixture of topsoil and vegetation and aggregate infills, with aggregate being used below the bridges where vegetation would have been difficult to establish. The last main application type will be concrete slopes. Concrete-filled GeoWeb, or hard armor slopes, are best used when there's going to be water flow and high flow situations. Here's a GeoWeb channel project that takes water runoff from the train intermodal yard. The GeoWeb system replaced the design that had originally called for 6 inches of reinforced concrete channels and 4-inch deep grout bag slope protection. The GeoWeb was a value engineering solution due to cost overruns. With 6 inches reinforced concrete in the channels and grout bags for the 2-to-1 slopes, switching the GeoWeb and the GeoWeb system saved the owner a couple $1 million, but more importantly, sped up construction and allowed the yard to be in service much quicker than originally planned for. The side slopes of the channel use 3-inch deep GeoWeb anchored with stakes because the slopes were short and relatively flat. The bottom of the channel used 4-inch GeoWeb so it could support vehicle access loading. This is another way the flexibility and versatility of the GeoWeb system can be used to create the right solution for your project requirements. The GeoWeb panels act as forms for the concrete, so there is no need to build additional formwork, which can be tricky on slopes and in any event extends construction time and cost. The concrete is poured from the top to the bottom, and cells hold the concrete in place and prevent it all from slumping and creating areas of uneven thickness. Speaking of thickness, another advantage of GeoWeb is that it assures consistent placement thickness. Pore pressure buildup is always a concern beneath concrete structures, so this project includes drilled weep holes through the set concrete to relieve that pressure. And here we can see the full extent of the project, which was more than 1 million square feet of GeoWeb, and saved the railroad a significant amount of money and installation time. This last section is just something additional I want to highlight, and that's how steep the slopes can get and still be protected from erosion. This was a project along the Pan American Highway in Peru, where the slope on each terrace was about 75 degrees. This was unique because these terraces were actually hand compacted to that angle, so they're not natural slopes. This project required tendons through every row of GeoWeb panels due to the steepness and the weight of the infill. Earth anchors were used at the crest of each slope because the dead man trench could not fit on top of these narrow terraces. They also chose to use a biaxial geogrid beneath the GeoWeb for additional soil control. And here's the final product. The vegetation has taken hold and the slopes are stable, even at such an extreme angle. The GeoWeb 3D Soil Confinement System has great flexibility of design and a variety of infills to meet your project needs. Steep slope protection is not out of the question when using the GeoWeb system. This is a complete system solution for ease of installation and peace of mind. A really quick plug for our engineering team. As many of you know, we provide free project design evaluations. The form is on our website, prestogeo.com. You fill it out with as much information as you have, including attaching documents such as geotechnical reports, and it comes to us. Then, within a few business days, we provide a complete design evaluation, including anchorage requirements and geotextile recommendations. We'll work with you to get the very best design for your project needs, in many times saving the end client time and money. And that's the presentation. Thank you. I want to thank you for attending and remind you that you can send questions to us and we'll respond immediately. Go to prestogeo.com for a wealth of information. And don't forget to view our YouTube videos found by clicking on the YouTube icon in the upper right corner of our webpage. A quick housekeeping note before we get to the questions. As an attendee, you'll receive a PDH certificate within one day, then a follow-up email from Presto Geosystems with helpful links and resources along with the recorded webinar. I'll answer some questions next, but if you have questions I don't get to, you can respond to the follow-up email and we'll be happy to answer your questions and help with any project recommendations. Thank you again for attending our webcast and be well. Now on to our questions. The first one asks, why does the material need to be virgin material? Wouldn't recycled be less expensive and better for the overall environment? This question touches on an important point. The virgin high-density polyethylene is chosen for its strength and semi-ductile properties. It gives the geocells the best erosion, the best environmental stress crack resistance, as well as the best weld strength, which is important, especially when we're talking steep slopes and maximum performance. We do not use exotic polymers or fillers that would certainly make it less expensive, but we do that to ensure your project can meet rigid standards and long-term project life. The next question, for a steep fill embankment, can the product be installed in 12-inch to 24-inch lifts? Installing in lifts like that, for many times a steep fill embankment or for road embankments, when you want something nearly vertical, we can use our GeoWeb installed horizontally instead of hanging like a curtain. That's more of our earth retention system. And our chief engineer, Brian, will be presenting on designing with the earth retention system coming up soon in a few weeks. Be sure to check back for that one. As we saw in the very last case study from Peru, you can install the GeoWeb slope protection system on very steep slopes and in terraces. The 12 to 14, in that particular case, I suggest sharing via the request for project evaluation link your specific site requirements, and we can look at a solution that would fit your needs best. The next question asks, how essential is the fabric before installation of the GeoWeb system? The geotextiles below serve as separation and many times reinforcement. If your infill material of the GeoWeb is the same as the material below the GeoWeb, you might not need any geotextile or fabrics. But in most cases, the infill is different from the subgrade, so you'd want to separate them to keep from pumping, mixing, or things of that nature. And in high clay or plasticity soils, we recommend a woven geotextile. Again, use our free design service and evaluation service with the request for project evaluation found on prestogeo.com, the link at the bottom of the screen. And we'd be happy to take a look and make a recommendation based on your project needs. The next question, how close do the side-by-side sections have to be connected? Most sections should abut, meaning they should be touching, and you use the atrachy to connect one cell to its neighbor all along the section. In the case where you have an obstacle such as a sonotube or a tree or the guardrail or fence, as shown in some of the photos, those cells around that obstacle can be left unconnected as long as their neighbors are connected adequately. Again, our design engineers can help out in such a case. A question particular to the very steep, almost 75-degree slopes, what was the infill used? In that case, it was topsoil that was vegetated. The next question is the cost per square of the geo system. For that one, there are so many variables with three different cell size openings, five different cell heights, five different section lengths, and a number of other attributes such as tendons or not, and other accessories such as anchorage. We recommend taking advantage of our free project evaluation service. Have us recommend the type of solution that best fits your project needs. And once we have a system to recommend, we'd be happy to provide, also at no cost, a quotation for that system. Next question, how long does it take for HDPE to decompose or disintegrate? We have lab testing from Segios at 149 years at full exposure. Most of the GEOWEB systems are integrated into the slopes they're protecting and are covered, so are not exposed, and they have very high environmental stress crack resistance as well, industry-leading values there. So certainly the life of the project, and in many cases, many more decades beyond that. If your project needs certain requirements for longevity and has extreme project lives being taken into consideration, please share that with our design team, and we'd be happy to incorporate those into the calculations. Next question, is the size of the geocell rock fill consistent for all slope applications, or does it change due to the slope steepness? Good question. It will vary by application and slope design. As a general rule of thumb, you can go with 1/4 to 1/3 the cell depth for the rock size, but it can vary. Again, our design engineers would be happy to look at your particular project needs and make your recommendation. Next question. For spillway repairs and maintenance, can the product be submerged during the wet season and still perform well during the dry season when exposed? Yes. In that case, you'd want to match the infill accordingly if you go from extreme dry to extreme wet or vice versa, and it's a vegetated channel, for example. You might want to consider something like an aggregate or grouted aggregate or even concrete in the extreme flow areas and vegetation in the non-flow areas. Many of our channels have such a combination, and the flexibility of the GEOWEB system performs very well in such a scenario. In this case, for the spillway repairs, again, please take advantage of our free evaluation service, and we'd be happy to make a recommendation based on your particular project. Next question, when installing in the very cold weather, HDPE tends to be very stiff. Have you had any difficulties installing in cold weather? For cold weather options, is there an option to have the materials utilizing low density polyethylene or other blends? In this case, the GEOWEB system has the optimal blend, and in many of the haul roads in Canada, we make the installations when the ground is frozen because it's over very soft subgrade conditions. Our global office is actually in Wisconsin, so we understand the cold weather and are happy to help provide some installation tips in this case. Again, please reach out as a follow-up to the email coming, and my team and I will be happy to respond with some additional tips. Next question, have you seen GEOWEB used under roads and in landslide repair? Can it work in conjunction with under drains or wicking? Yes to all of that. Many of our case studies include GEOWEB as the base stabilization beneath paved roadways, and it is often used in roadslide and landslide repair. In that case, often as the embankment repair as a earth retention system. The underdrains and wicking geotextiles can be included as part of our recommendation with the evaluation. Again, please reach out to our design engineering team for activating that free service. Next question, for steep slopes and in arid areas, can irrigation systems be installed within the system? GEOWEB is a highly flexible system, and in this case, yes, as long as you're planning for the irrigation systems to fit within the GEOWEB constraints, we can certainly include and allow for that as part of our recommendation and the evaluation. Again, please reach out to our design engineering team and we can include that accordingly. There are a few more questions, many of them dealing with cost and project specific questions. So we'll pause there. Again, thank you for your attention and participation today. Within one day, you'll receive a PDH certificate and then a follow-up email from Presto with helpful links and resources along with the recorded webinar. Thank you for your time today. Be well.